In this video, I'm going to show you the two best ways of getting your project from Premiere Pro to DaVinci to color grade it. We are here in Premiere Pro. This is the first technique. This is going to be the simpler of the techniques, but you'll see each technique has its ups and downs. What you are going to do is you're in Premiere Pro, you create a new timeline, you remove all effects and transitions, and you make sure all the clips are right next to each other in the same channel. So I've done this here. Technique one is going to be a straightforward ProRes export. Go export. We want to export it the highest quality we can. So you'll either go 444 or 444XQ. And then you export it. I've already done this, so we save time. You go back to DaVinci. You look for your export. You get your export. You say cutscene detection. And you auto cutscene. Now let's make sure that it did the cutting correctly. I'm going to use N on the keyboard to see. Yes, that's right. Right. Correct. Perfect. It cut everything in the right way. I'm going to go add cuts to media pool. Now all my cuts are in here. Let's call this technique one. Now all the footage is in there. All you need to do is from start to finish, I press shift to select everything. And then I just put it in my timeline. And now we have an exact copy of the timeline in Premiere Pro. So what are the benefits on this technique? Well, A, we know the scaling, we know everything is exactly the same as it was in Premiere Pro. B, if you're working with the colorist, you're sending the files somewhere or receiving it, it's a lot smaller than sending the raw files. What is the con? You're still working with ProRes 444. It's not bad, but it's not as good as raw. So your image is going to break easier when you start really grading it. Now, let me show you technique two. And this is the one I use as much as I can. Let's go back to Premiere, back to the timeline. So technique two, we are going to work with the XML. A normal thing people do is they say, okay, the timeline is good. I'm just going to go file, export, XML, and now I'm finished. And you can do that, but there's a big problem when you do that. If you do it that way and you have the XML, if you have a hard drive, right, full of, let's say, 3 days of raw footage, if you want the colorist to work on it, you have to send that entire hard drive, all of the files and the XML together. So if you're working with the colorist that's remote, you're going to have to ship a hard drive, which we don't always want to do. So this technique that I'm going to talk about only extracts the raw footage in your timeline and links an XML. So you don't need to send all the footage, even footage you don't use, to make it work. So this way, your footage that you're working with will be a lot smaller, but you still be working with raw. I'll show you how it works. You're going to do exactly the same thing. You're going to create a new timeline, no effects, no transitions. You're going to put the files next to each other. Make sure they're ungraded. This is good. Now we are going to go file, project manager. Not consolidate and transcode. We're going to go collect files and copy to new location. It's going to collect all of these raw files that's in your timeline and put it in a specific folder. And that's what you're going to share with the colorist. So you go new folder here, and we're going to say new raw files. We're going to say choose, and we're going to say okay. So now Premiere has moved all of these raw files into a new folder and has ignored any other type of file that you have not used. Second step, file, export, the XML. We're going to call this, let's just call this technique two. I'm going to go save. I'm going to go back to DaVinci. I'm going to find the file that I pushed all the raw footage in, or the raw footage that's in that timeline that we're using, which I saved as, if I can remember. Oh yeah. New raw files. I'm going to right click, add folder and subfolders. Okay, now we got new raw files, technique one. Go back here. Now I'm going to create a new timeline. I'm going to import the XML I just exported from Premiere. So the XML tells DaVinci which files to link on the timeline. We said technique two. I'm going to say okay. Use sizing information, no. Automatically set project settings, yes. Automatically import source clips? No, because I just automatically import source clips into media pool. We're going to say no, because I already did that manually. Okay. I was going to ask you, where are the files I need to use? It's new raw files. Okay. Great. Everything linked nicely. Now this timeline is exactly the same. is the previous timeline. I'll just rename this to make it easier. So I'll do technique two, right? And I created a timeline in here, which is technique one. And I'll just move this to here. So it's a little bit easier to see. Technique one, technique two. So technique one, where we took ProRes. So see here, exact copy of the Premiere timeline. But you'll see all of these files are ProRes. They're not raw. Now technique two is exactly the same, but you're working with the raw files. So your end project is going to be way better because the colorist has more to play around with. Now before you import this technique two and say, oh, it's great, it's fine. One con with this technique two is sometimes the sizing information is not correct. With this technique one, it's exactly the same. You don't have to worry about it. But this technique two, there's an extra step you need to do. So we're going to go back to Premiere Pro and we need to export a reference file to double check that everything lined up correctly. How you do that is you'll go export. We are going to go 8264. It doesn't matter the quality. We just want to see if the sizing is correct. Then you go export. I've done this so that we also save some time. And this is the reference. This is the export from Premiere Pro, the 8264 one. And what you do is you go here, you right click on it and you say add as offline reference clip. Go edit. Now we need to link that offline reference clip to our timeline, which is technique two. We right click timeline, link offline. Find it, ref. If nothing comes up here, you got to make sure this dropdown is select on offline. Now it is synced up with our timeline. Now we just double check. Here's the sizing correct. So now we can do it with our eye. Or what we can do is you go on this, right click, difference. If there's a difference, it's going to show. If it's black, it means it's an exact copy. Then you go clip by clip. You make sure there's no differences. And if there is a difference, you just go into the transform and you move around the sizing so that it matches. Once everything is lined up, you are ready to grade. You'll grade it. And when you want to export this and send it back to your editor, what you do is you go to the delivery page. You have a look here. It says Premiere XML. Click on that. We're going to go ProRes 444. Render at source resolution. Force. Force. And then when you export it, the editor can just take those ProRes 444 files and put it back in their timeline. So think about these two techniques. Sometimes one is better than the other. Usually if it's remote work, the first technique is good because you send a ProRes, they cut it up. But the end product is not going to be as good because you're not working with RAW. If you have good internet and when you do this technique two, the RAW files are not as big, I would suggest always trying to go with technique two. Because if you give a colorist the raw footage, it is just at the end of the day going to look better.